Now that we have seen the equivalent circuit of transmission line, we will use this equivalent circuit of transmission line to derive the very important voltage and current equations. Later, after deriving these voltage and current equations, we find that these voltages and currents are nothing but waves. So, even before we derive the voltage and current equations, let us understand what exactly is a wave. So, the initial discussion will be on the wave as well as the wave equation. Now, this topic requires certain level of imagination. So, because which wherever required, I have used necessary animations, and these animations have been placed at the end of this lecture. So, if at all you have a problem at any point of this particular topic, please go through that animations, and I am very sure that whatever doubt you have will be cleared. Now, coming back to the topic, wave is something that we see in our day-to-day life. Whenever I drop a stone in the middle of a pond, I can see some water waves being created, and these water waves will travel away from the point where the stone has been dropped. Similarly, whenever I plug the string of a guitar, there again I can observe some mechanical waves on top of the string of the guitar. I can experience sound waves. I can also experience the electromagnetic waves, at least in the form of a mobile phone or at least in the form of a light. So waves are always present around us. Now, what exactly is a wave? Wave is any quantity which is a function of space and time. So, this is any quantity which is a function of space and time. So, can I say any function which varies with respect to space and time is a wave? The answer is no. For example, temperature. Temperature of Hyderabad throughout the day, will it remain constant? The answer is no. Whenever the time changes, the temperature also will change. Similarly, at the same instant of time, for example, at 10 a.m., if I measure the temperature of various cities in the country, will the temperature of all the cities be same? The answer is again no. So indicates what? Temperature changes with respect to time. Temperature also changes with respect to space. So can I call temperature as a wave? The answer is no. That is because this definition of a wave is incomplete. So wave should be a function of space and time, but at the same time, it also has to satisfy something called wave equation. And also has to satisfy something called wave equation. So the next topic that we will discuss about is a wave equation. Wave equation is given by del square u by del x square is equal to 1 by c square del square u by del t square, where here the function is in this equation u of x comma t, and whichever function satisfies this equation will be called as a wave. Moreover, that function has to vary with respect to both space and time, and in this function, this term c represents the velocity of the wave travel. So here the term c corresponds to the velocity of wave travel. Moreover, the term x here represents the direction along which wave exists. So c here is the velocity of wave travel, whereas x here represents the direction along which the wave exists. If at all the wave exists along some z direction, in that case we will replace this x with z. And moreover, since the wave is existing along only one direction, we can say that this is the equation of a wave in one dimension. And if at all we want to write the generalized form of the wave, it can be written as del square u is equal to 1 by c square del square u by del t square. This is the equation of the wave in a generalized case. We have not yet discussed the del operator, so because which we don't have to bother about the second equation. And in fact, in our course of transmission lines, we will deal only with this equation. We won't even have to bother about the second equation. This is the equation that we will use generally in our EM waves, electromagnetic waves, as well as antennas, as well as in the topic of the wave guides. But rather in transmission lines, this equation is more than sufficient to understand the concept of waves. Now let us see a few examples with respect to the waves. Here we have been given a few, you can say, equations, and we are supposed to tell which of these equations are waves. Now for any function to be called as a wave, it should satisfy two conditions. The first is the function has to be a function of space and time. The second is that function has to satisfy the wave equation. And what is the wave equation? The wave equation is del square f by del x square is equal to 1 by c square del square f by del t square. Here the function is f in all the cases, so because which I have written in terms of f. So whichever function satisfies this equation, apart from being a function of space and time, we will call that function as a wave. In the first case, what is the value of del square f by del x square? That is equal to, whenever you differentiate this with respect to x partial differentiation, you will get what value now? You will get it as differential of cos is nothing but minus sign. And when you differentiate minus sign again, you will get minus cos. So overall, I can say that this differential equation is equal to, and apart from that, you will also get beta outside. You will get this equation as minus beta square into cos of omega t minus beta x. Similarly, whenever you differentiate the function with respect to time, del square f by del t square, now what do you get this equation as? Now double differentiation again will lead to a minus term, and further, since you are differentiating with respect to time, this omega comes out twice, so because which it becomes equal to minus omega square cos of omega t minus beta x. So is this function satisfying the wave equation? The answer is yes, because if you notice, what is this term? This is nothing but f, and here also this is nothing but f. So according to the first equation, what is f? F is equal to minus 1 by beta square into this term, and I will replace that value of f in the second case. So f is equal to minus 1 by beta square into del square f by del x square, and this value of f is replaced in the second case. And whenever you do that, what will you get now? You will get the equation as del square f by del t square is equal to minus omega square, and the beta square comes to the denominator, minus beta square in the denominator, into that is del square f by del x square, and the minus and minus sign gets cancelled. And if at all you call omega by beta as a constant called c, so in that case, how can you transform this equation? It can be rewritten as del square f by del x square is equal to, this is equal to 1 by c square del square f by del t square, where c is equal to what? C is equal to omega by beta. So can I call the first function as a wave? The answer is yes. You can call the first function as a wave because it's a function of time and space. Moreover, it is satisfying the wave equation. Similarly, whenever you take the second function, first of all, is it a function of space and time? Yes. So the first condition is satisfied, and you double differentiate del square f by del x square. What do you get now? Whenever you double differentiate this term, sine term, you will get minus sine again. So because which this is minus sine cos t. And what about del square f by del t square? That becomes equal to minus sine cos t. Because whenever you double differentiate cos, what will you get? You will get minus cos. So from this, what can you say? From this we can say that del square f by del x square is equal to del square f by del t square, and I can write that velocity term as 1 by 1 square. So because which is this function, that is the second function, satisfying the wave equation? Definitely yes. If you correlate this function and this function, there seems to be a semblance in such a way that c is equal to 1, that is the velocity of wave travel is equal to 1. So can I call the second function also as a wave? Yes, the first function is a wave, the second function is also a wave. In fact, there is a name given to this function. This is called as a traveling wave, and whereas this function is called as a standing wave. And what about this wave? If you notice, whenever I double differentiate this function with respect to x, this is del square f by del x square. What do you get now? When you differentiate it once, you will get it as 2 into x plus 2t, and when you double differentiate, you will get it as 2. So this becomes equal to 2. And the same function, whenever you double differentiate with respect to time now, del square f by del t square becomes how much? 8. And can I observe a relation between these two? Yes. So I can write it as del square f by del x square. Now this is equal to 2, whereas this is equal to 8, and because of which I can write it as 1 by 4 times del square f by del t square. So this is what I have. Now please observe that, is it again satisfying the wave equation? Yes. I can write c square as nothing but 4, c is equal to 2. So indicates the velocity of the wave travel is 2. So this is also satisfying the wave equation. So because which I can call this function also as a wave. What about this function now? Now here, if I differentiate this function del square f by del x square, what will I get now? 0. And what about del square f by del t square? What will I get now? Also as 0. So can I say that this function is satisfying the wave equation, that is del square f by del x square is equal to del square f by del t square, because both are 0. So can I call this function as a wave? The answer is no. Because first of all, this function is not a function of space and time. It's only a function of space, and it is not varying with respect to time. So the first condition itself has been violated. So because which, even though it is satisfying the apparent wave equation, but still we won't call it as a wave. Only those functions which are functions of space and time satisfying the wave equation will be called as a wave. In all the first three cases, we are having functions which are functions of space and time, space and time, space and time. But here we don't have any time component, so because which, even though it is satisfying the wave equation, we won't call it this, we won't call this as a wave. The waves that we see around can be either classified as a longitudinal waves, or it can be a transverse waves. So the wave can be either a longitudinal wave, or it can be a transverse wave. Now in longitudinal wave, the direction of oscillation of particles will be along the direction of propagation. So here the direction of oscillation of particles or components, they will be along the direction of travel. Along the wave travel. For example, let us say I am having some particles. This is one particle, this is one more particle, and this is one more particle, this is one more particle, and so on. कि दीज आर द पार्टिकल्स दैट वी हैव एंड बाय स्टैंडिंग ऑन वन साइड आई गिव अ पुश टू द फर्स्ट पार्टिकल व्हाट विल हैपन दिस पार्टिकल विल मूव एंड हिट द सेकंड पार्टिकल एंड विल कम बैक टू इट्स ओरिजिनल पोजिशन सो इट विल मूव फॉरवर्ड एंड अगेन कम बैक टू इट्स ओरिजिनल पोजिशन सो इन दैट प्रोसेस द फर्स्ट पार्टिकल हैज ट्रांसफर्ड सम मोमेंटम टू द सेकंड पार्टिकल सो वॉट विल दिस सेकंड पार्टिकल डू नाउ इट विल गो एंड हिट द थर्ड पार्टिकल and again come back to its original position. So it came back to its original position. But again in that process what happened? This particle has transferred some amount of energy to the third particle and so on. So third particle also will move forward, come back. Fourth particle move forward, come back. Fifth particle move forward, come back. And finally the energy has been transferred to the last particle and the last particle will continue to move forward. So in that process what happened? In that process what happened is the energy from first particle has been transferred to the last particle. So can I say that this is the direction of the energy propagation? Yes. So energy has been propagated along this direction. And if you look at the direction of oscillation of the particle, is it along the same direction as compared to that of the wave propagation? Yes. If you see this direction and this direction, are they not parallel? Yes. And such kind of waves are called as longitudinal waves. And the examples of longitudinal waves are nothing but the sound waves. And in our course of electromagnetics, we don't deal with longitudinal waves. So we don't have to bother about what is the equation of a longitudinal wave and what is the analysis of a longitudinal wave. Now let us look at the other category of waves, which is nothing but transverse waves. In transverse waves, the direction of oscillation of particle will not be along the direction of wave travel, but rather it will be perpendicular to the wave travel. So here the direction of the oscillation, the direction of oscillation of particles or components, the wave components will be perpendicular to the wave travel, the wave travel direction. So in that case we will call that wave as transverse waves. And the examples of transverse waves is nothing but the water waves, water waves, as well as the waves on top of the on a guitar string, and more importantly our electromagnetic waves. So in our course we are mainly interested in learning about the transverse waves, and I'll take a similar kind of an example. Let us say I'm having a group of particles. Again, these are the group of particles. And these group of particles are bounded now, bounded with respect to each other. So now let us say I move this particle up and down. So I take this particle up and again I can bring it down to the original position. In that case what will happen? Since the first particle and second particle are both connected with respect to each other, whenever you move the first particle up, don't you think after some time, after a time delay, the second particle also will move up and down? Yes. So whenever the second particle will move up and down, and after one more, some more time delay, in that case the third particle also will move up and down. So in that process what will happen? The last particle slowly will also move up and down. So whenever you move this first particle up and down, in that process the second particle will also move up and down, the third particle will also move up and down, and the last particle also moves up and down, and so on. In that process what happened? Are you not transferring the energy from the first particle to the second, second to the third, and so on? Yes. So here this is the direction in which the energy is being transferred. This is the direction of energy transfer. And is the direction of oscillation of the particle along the same direction of energy transfer or perpendicular to the direction of energy transfer? Definitely you can see that this is perpendicular to the direction of energy transfer. So because of which we will call such kind of a wave as nothing but a transverse wave. Furthermore, transverse waves are categorized into the standing waves as well as the traveling waves. So the transverse waves are classified as a standing wave as well as a traveling wave. Let us now see what exactly is a standing wave and what exactly is a traveling wave. Traveling wave, as the name implies, is a wave which travels. So this is a wave which travels. So since it travels, it is capable of energy transfer. So this wave, since it travels, is capable of energy transfer. What does a wave travel mean? Wave travel mean that the location where you are having a maxima or minima, that will continuously change with respect to time. See, if at all you notice the stone dropped in the middle of a pond, you see what? You see that a wave is created, and this wave will move forward in the sense that this is the point where you are having maxima, no? That is in space. This is the location where you are having the maxima. Now, whenever this wave travels, what will happen is after some instant of time, let us say this is the shape of the wave after some instant of time t2 greater than t1. This is the shape of the wave at t1 instant of time. Now, in this case, where are you having maximum amplitude? At this location. Now, at this location, you are having the maximum amplitude. Indicates the point of maximum amplitude changes from this position to this position whenever time changes. So, in a traveling wave, the location of maxima or the location of minima should continuously change with respect to time in a particular direction. So that is nothing but the wave travel mean. And the general form of traveling wave is of this kind. U of x comma t, the equation of a traveling wave, will be of the order a naught cos of omega t plus or minus beta x. So this is a general form of a traveling wave. In fact, to be even more general, we can also introduce some phase shift here. Okay, you can write it as cos of omega t plus or minus beta x plus phi. It doesn't matter. Okay, in fact, we shall write it. We can write it as plus phi. And this phi is a phase difference which is a constant value. So this is a general form of a traveling wave. Furthermore, the traveling waves that we have can be either classified as a forward or a positive traveling wave. Or it can be a backward or negative traveling wave. So it can also be a backward or negative traveling wave. In this generalized case, the traveling waves travel in the direction of x. So this indicates the direction of wave travel. So here we are simply saying that the wave travels along the x direction, but along the positive x direction or along the negative x direction, that I can't say. That depends upon the sign that you have here. So this can be either plus x direction or minus x direction. But only thing I can say is it is traveling along the x direction. Depending upon the sign that you have here or the sign that you have here, we can say that a particular wave is a forward wave or a backward wave. A positive traveling wave is that wave, in this case, which travels in the direction of positive x, or a negative traveling wave is that wave which travels in the direction of minus x. So let us see now how to decide the direction of a particular wave. Now let us look at the forward traveling wave. Forward traveling wave is also called as positive traveling wave. So this is also called as a positive traveling wave. And the general equation for a forward traveling wave is given by u of f x comma t. F here indicates forward. This is equal to some amplitude a into cos of omega t minus beta x. So the minus here indicates the wave is traveling in the positive direction. So the minus sign here indicates positive travel, whereas the plus sign here indicates a negative travel. So here it's exactly the opposite. We will also see why is that so. Now let us for the time being accept that whenever you have a minus sign here, we are having a positive travel, and whenever you have a plus sign here, we will have a negative travel. In fact, we will show both these scenarios. Now tell me, when will this function be maximum? This function will be maximum. This function is maximum whenever the RHS is also maximum. The RHS, which is a cos term, because the amplitude is a constant term, whenever you want UF to be maximum, cos term also has to be maximum. And when will this cos term be maximum? Whenever this phase is equal to zero. So that is possible whenever omega t minus beta x is equal to zero. So from this, what is the value of x? X is equal to omega t by beta. We know that omega is equal to how much? This is 2 pi by capital T, where capital T is a time period, and beta is equal to 2 pi by lambda. And whenever I substitute these two equations here, the equation of x comes out to be a value of, this is equal to, whenever you rewrite the equation, it is lambda into T by capital T. Now tell me, what is this x? This x is the location in space where this function of uf of x comma t is maximum, where uf of x comma t is maximum. Okay, so let us now analyze this particular equation as well as this particular mathematical equation. So let us say I'll plot the graph of this function at three different instances of time. Now the first instance of time is at t equal to 0, and let us say this is the line corresponding to x equal to 0. Now whenever at t equal to 0 we take, where do we have the maxima? Maxima occurs at x equal to 0, so because of which the shape of the wave looks something of this kind, and so on. And as you can notice, we are having maxima at x equal to 0. So this is the shape of the wave at t equal to 0. And if you notice, this point and this point are having the same phase, so because which I can say that this location in space is the location where x is equal to lambda, because after one wavelength the shape of the wave repeats in itself. So because which, what is this point now? In between x equal to 0 and x equal to lambda, you will have lambda by 2. So I can say that this is a location in space which is lambda by 2. So this is x equal to lambda by 2. So we got that at x equal to, or at t equal to t by 2, where are you having the maximum value? The maximum value occurs at lambda by 2. So because which the shape of the function at t equal to capital T by 2 will be of this order. And so on. So this is the shape of the wave at t equal to capital T by 2. And further, at t equal to capital T, where are you having the maxima? The maximum value occurs at x equal to lambda. So because which at this location is where you should have the maxima. So because of which the shape will be exactly same as compared to what we had got in the previous case, that is nothing but a t equal to 0 case. So the shape will look something like this. And so on. So if I notice, initially we had the maximum value at this location, and whenever time increased, by the way, this is the plot at t equal to capital T. So we had the maxima initially at this particular location, and whenever time progressed, this maximum value shifted to this location now, and after some more time, the location where the function is maximum is shifted to this particular point. So if you notice, the maximum value shifted from this point to this point to this point, that is the location where we are having the maxima shifted in this particular way. So if you notice, this particular wave is traveling in what direction? This particular wave is traveling in the rightward direction. So since it is traveling in the rightward direction, or the rightward direction is a direction where x increases, so this is the direction where the x increases, indicates this is a positive x direction. So in the present case, the wave is traveling in what direction? The wave is simply traveling in the positive direction of x. So because of which, this is a positive traveling wave. So whenever you see a minus here, simply you can say that this is a wave which travels in the positive direction. One more very simple way of understanding the wave travel direction is by looking at this equation itself. If you notice here, whenever t increases, the value of x increases or decreases? The value of x increases. Indicates as time progresses, the location where you are having the maxima also will increase. So because of which, since x is increasing, the function, or this particular function, will travel in the direction of positive x. And hence, this wave is called as the forward wave. So whenever you see a minus here, you can say that this is a wave which travels in positive direction of x. Similar to forward wave travel, we'll also have backward wave travel. Backward wave travel is also called as a negative traveling wave, because this negative traveling wave will travel in the negative direction of the space. Now the general form of the backward traveling wave is given by uv of x comma t is equal to a into cos of omega t plus beta x. So whenever you see a plus sign here, it means the wave is traveling in the negative direction. Now when will this function be maximum? This function is maximum whenever this phase angle is equal to 0. So because of which, whenever omega t plus beta x is equal to 0, we will have the function to be maximum. So accordingly, what is the value of x now? X is equal to minus omega t by beta. Or I can rewrite it as x is equal to minus lambda into t by t. Time always increases, time will never decrease. So whenever time increases here, please observe, time increases indicates, so whenever time increases, you are having a negative value of x or positive value of x. You do have a negative value of x. And this negative value of x, is it increasing in magnitude or decreasing in magnitude? It is increasing in magnitude. So because of which, I can say, whenever time increases, this x corresponds to the location where the function ub of x comma t is maximum. So whenever your time increases, in that case, the value of x decreases. Can I say that? Yes, because the magnitude of negative value is increasing. So whenever the magnitude of negative value increases, in that case, the overall value of x will decrease. So whenever time increases, your x is decreasing. So indicates the location where you are having the maxima is decreasing. So you are moving backwards in the direction of minus x. So because of which, we can say that whenever you are having a function of this particular kind, we can say that this function is a backward wave. See, whenever you do the waveform analysis for this, it looks exactly similar as compared to what we had got in the previous case. In the class notes, I've already given how the wave becomes a backward traveling wave. But here I'm not doing it because, you know, the discussion will be exactly same as compared to what we had done in the forward traveling wave case. And as I told you, that can also be explained by using this equation also. This equation also tells us that whenever time increases, the value of negative x value also will increase. Negative x value increases means what? We are moving in the direction of minus x. So that's what it says. So since you are traveling in the direction of minus x, this wave is a negative traveling wave. Now that we have seen the concept of traveling waves, let us use the concept of traveling waves to understand one more category of wave, which is the standing wave. So let us now discuss about the standing wave. Let us say I'm having two waves, and these two waves are having same amplitude as well as they have same frequency. And when these two waves having the same amplitude and frequency travel in opposite directions and interact with each other, then a standing wave is formed. So a standing wave is formed whenever we have two traveling waves traveling in opposite directions. But as I told you, that these two traveling waves should have same frequency as well as same amplitude. So whenever these conditions are satisfied, that is, two traveling waves having same amplitude and frequency travel in opposite directions, in that case we will have a standing wave being formed. Since we already studied about the traveling waves, and we have seen that the traveling waves can be either a forward traveling wave or it can be a backward traveling wave. So let us write the equation for the forward traveling wave. The forward traveling wave is having an equation of a naught cos of omega t minus beta x. So the minus sign here indicates that this is a positive traveling wave. So this is a positive traveling wave. And furthermore, what is the direction of travel? It is traveling in the direction of positive x. So this x indicates the direction of wave travel, and the minus sign here indicates that this wave is traveling in the direction of plus x. So whenever we have a minus here, direction of wave travel is plus x. And whenever we have a plus x here, the direction of wave travel is minus x. And what about the wave traveling in the negative direction? That will be given by a naught cos of omega t plus beta x. So this is a negative traveling wave. How can you say? By this sign. So whenever we see a plus sign here, indicates this is a negative traveling wave. So this is a negative traveling wave. And how can you say that these waves are traveling? Earlier, if you remember, this function will have a maxima when this function will have a maxima whenever this term is 0, because cos 0 is equal to 1 indicates the function is maxima. So omega t minus beta x has to be equal to 0. I'm just writing it separately. So that particular first wave will have a maxima whenever omega t minus beta x is equal to 0. So accordingly, can I say that x is equal to what? Omega t by beta. This is the location where we are having the maxima. Now if you notice, whenever time increases, the location where we are having that maxima, is it also changing? Yes. So indicates what? It means the energy is transferred from one location to the other, because of which we can say that both these waves are traveling in space. Now let us simplify this equation. Whenever I simplify this equation, what I will get is nothing but, now this is cos of A minus B. What is cos of A minus B? It is cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. Whereas this is cos of A plus B. The equation of cos of A plus B is nothing but cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. So because of which the first equation is A naught cos of omega t cos of beta x, and the other term here is plus sin of omega t sin of beta x. Whereas for the second term you are having the equation as cos of omega t cos of beta x and minus sin of omega t sin of beta x. And I can cancel out the sin terms here. So finally I will get the resultant equation as this is equal to 2a naught cos of omega t cos of beta x. And this resultant equation I will call it as us of x comma t. Again, the resultant equation, is it a function of space and time? Yes. So can I call it as a wave? Yes. In fact, we have taken such kind of example when we are defining the waves. So there we have seen that this general form of equation is also a wave. And this wave will be called as the standing wave. But why we are calling it as standing? See, simply tell me one thing. What does standing means? Standing means that we are not moving. So similarly, here also whenever we say that the wave is standing, it means that it is not traveling in space. How can you confirm that? By looking at this term. If I look at this term, we are having cos of beta x. Now please tell me, when will this function be maxima? Whenever cos beta x is equal to 1. And when will cos beta x becomes equal to 1? Cos beta x becomes equal to 1 whenever beta x is equal to 0 or plus or minus 2 pi or plus or minus 4 pi, etc. So because which this function, that is nothing but cos beta x becomes equal to 1, cos beta x is equal to 1 indicates u of x comma t, this is maxima. So I can say that the location where the function is maxima is nothing but whenever the cos beta x becomes equal to 1. Now please tell me beta x, when it will be equal to 1? Cos beta x becomes equal to 1 whenever beta x is equal to 0 or plus or minus 2 pi or plus or minus 4 pi and so on. And here this x corresponds to what? This x is a location in space where us of x comma t is maxima. So this x corresponds to the location in space where the function is maxima. Now this location where the function is maxima, is it a function of time? The answer is no, because we don't have a time term here. So because of which the location in space where this particular function is maxima is not a function of time. So as time progresses, the location where we are having the maxima, will it also propagate in space? The answer is no. So because of which in this case we can't have any energy transfer. So in standing waves there is no energy transfer from one location to the other location. We can simply store energy in the form of a standing wave, but rather we can't transfer energy in the form of a standing wave. So because of which we are calling that this wave as a standing wave, because whenever time progresses with respect to time, the value of x here is not changing. So because of which this wave is not moving or this wave is not traveling, it is simply standing in space. The locations of maxima and minima are fixed. So since the locations of maxima and minima are fixed, the wave is not traveling. Whereas here if you notice, I told you that this is the condition for one of these waves, the one of these traveling waves to be maxima. And whenever omega t minus beta x equal to 0, In that case, x equal to omega t by beta. Now here notice, whenever time increases, so x also will increase. Here also, what is x? Here also x corresponds to the location in space where this function is maxima. And the location where the function is maxima, is it not changing with respect to time? Yes. So because which, continuously at various locations will have maximum values whenever the time increases. So because which, this wave is traveling, whereas this wave is standing in space. Let us now look at the waveform for the standing wave. So here we will see how the standing wave changes with respect to both space and time. So we got the equation for the standing wave as us of x comma t is equal to 2 a naught cos of omega t into cos of beta x. In this case, the cos omega t is a time term, whereas cos beta x is a space term. And I am separating the cos omega t and plotting it in this particular fashion. So since this is a cos wave, the x-axis is taken as omega t, which is nothing but the angle. And whenever omega t equal to 0, the amplitude of function is 1. Omega t equal to 60, the amplitude is 0.5. Omega t equal to 90, the amplitude is 0. Omega t equal to 120, the amplitude is minus 0.5, and so on up till omega t equal to 360. So I have considered one full waveform of cos omega t. So indicates I have considered one entire period of the waveform. So after 360 degrees, what will happen? The shape of the wave will repeat in itself. So I called the time instances as at time instant 1 omega t equal to 0, at time instant 2 omega t equal to 60 degrees, at time instant 3 omega t is 90, at time instant 4 the omega t is 120, at time instant 5 180, at time instant 6 240, at 7 270, at 8 300, and finally at 9 we are having 360 degrees. And at all these time instances, we know the amplitudes by simply knowing the cos relation. But I want to write the equation of us of x comma t at all these time instances. So at time instant 1, that is at this instant of time, the amplitude of cos omega t is how much? It is equal to 1. So whenever I replace cos omega t with 1, what will you get? You will get that function as 2 a naught cos of beta x. So at time instant 1, the equation of the function is us of x comma t becomes equal to 2 a naught cos of beta x, because cos omega t becomes equal to 1 at omega t equal to 0. Now do we have any other instant of time where the value of cos omega t is equal to 1? Yes, that is at instant 9. At instant 9, whenever omega t equal to 360 degrees, cos 360 is how much? 1. So because of which, at instant 1 as well as at instant 9, we are having the equation of us of x comma t is equal to 2 a naught cos of beta x. In fact, I am not supposed to write this as u of x comma t, because we have already fixed the time. And at what time? Either at time instant 0, that is time instant 1, or time instant 9. So in that case, we are having the equation as 2 a naught cos beta x. Now tell me, what is the value of cos omega t at time instant 2? At time instant 2, angle is 60. Whenever angle is 60, cos 60 is 0.5. And whenever I substitute cos omega t as 0.5, what will you get? 2 a naught into 0.5 is nothing but a naught. So at time instant 2, the equation of us of x comma t is equal to a naught. Now it's not 2 a naught cos of beta x. And further, at what other time instant you are having the value of cos omega t as 0.5? It is nothing but at time instant 8. So both at time instant 2 and as well as at time instant 8, we got the equation of us of x comma t to be exactly the same as the equation at time instant 2. Now at time instant 3, what is the angle? 90 degrees, cos 90 is 0. So because which, whenever I replace this term with 0, the entire equation becomes equal to 0. So at time instant 3 now, the equation of us of x comma t is equal to 0. And at what other time instant you are having the function to be equal to 0, that is cos omega t is 0, that is at 270 degrees. That is at time instant 7. So at 3 and 7 time instants, 2 time instants, the value of function becomes equal to 0. Further, at time instant 4, if you observe, the value of cos omega t, angle is 120, cos 120 is minus 0.5. And whenever you take this minus 0.5 and substitute it here, what will you get? 2a0 into minus 0.5 is minus a0. So because which at time instant 4, the function us of x comma t becomes equal to minus a0 cos of beta x. Why? Because as I told you, at time instant 4, cos omega t is minus 0.5. Minus 0.5 will be substituted here. 2a0 into minus 0.5 is minus a0. And at what other instant of time you are having cos omega t to be equal to minus 0.5? It is at instant 6. So at 4 comma 6, the equation of that function remains exactly the same. What about at time instant 5? At time instant 5, angle is 180, cos 180 is minus 1. Whenever you substitute this term as minus 1, you will get the equation as minus 2a0 cos beta x. So us of x comma t becomes equal to minus 2a0 cos of beta x. Now let us plot these space plots. If you observe, now here all these functions are only a function of x. Now let us plot these space functions in this particular waveform. Now here we already have the space term. The amplitude here, let us say, is 2a0. This is 2a0. And can you notice that here the value of x is equal to 0, and at the other extreme the value of x is equal to lambda. So indicates we are observing the shape of the wave for one full wavelength. And after this location, what will happen? The shape of the wave will repeat in itself. So it is sufficient for us to analyze one full wavelength. Like in the previous case, we have taken time only for one entire time period. Similarly, here also in space, it is sufficient for us to analyze the shape of the wave for one full wavelength. Now at time instant 1, the equation of us of x comma t is equal to how much? It is equal to 2a0 cos beta x. And here the amplitude is 2a0 we have taken, and this is a shape of a cos wave. So because which at time instant 1, as well as at time instant 9, the shape remains exactly the same. And what about at time instant 2 now? At time instant 2, the equation is a0 cos beta x. So because which the shape, now also it is nothing but cos beta x term. So the shape remains same, amplitude will change. So because which the shape of the wave looks something like this. In the sense that this amplitude becomes equal to how much now? This amplitude is a0. And this is the shape of the wave when at time instant 2 as well as at time instant 8. And what is the shape of the wave at time instant 3 as well as 7? It is 0. So because which? A flat line. So at every location in space, the amplitude becomes equal to 0. So this is the shape of the wave at time instant 3 as well as at time instant 7. And what about at time instant 4? At time instant 4 as well as at time instant 6, the equation is minus a0 cos beta x. Now also you are having cos beta x term, but rather it is minus a0 cos beta x. And what is the shape of that function now? It looks something like this. Simply the previous wave inverted. The wave at time instant 2 simply inverted now. Now this amplitude again would be how much? The magnitude of this amplitude is equal to a0. Magnitude is a0, but rather in the negative direction. And when do you have this shape of the waveform? This is the shape of the waveform at time instant both 4 and 6. At both 4 as well as at 6, you are having the shape to be of this kind. What is the shape of the waveform at time instant 5? It is minus 2a0 cos beta x. Again, we are having a negative wave, but rather with double the amplitude. So because which the shape looks something like this. In such a way that this entire magnitude is equal to 2a0. 2a0 in the negative direction. So So this is the shape of the wave at time instant 5. Notice now that how the shape of the wave is changing with respect to time. Please mind that this is a spatial plot. This is a plot in space of the amplitude of the wave. Now at time instant 1, this is the shape. At time instant 2, you are reaching here. At time instant 3, here, 4, 5, again 6, 7, 8, 9. And after 9, what will happen? You'll again go back to 2, because you know that's how the cycle goes. You are starting from omega d equal to 0 till 360, and after 360 the cycle repeats, because 360 is equivalent to the phase angle 0. So after 1 you are having 2, so 9 and 1 are equivalent. So after 9, since 9 is equivalent to 1, you will have 2, and so on. The shape of the wave will repeat in itself, and the shape looks something like this. At time instant 1, this is the shape of the wave. At time instant 2, this is the shape of the wave. At time instant 3, it is flat. At time instant 4, it is inverted U. And at time instant 5, it is very steep inverted U. 6, again, the shape is similar to the time instant 4 shape. And at 7, again, it is flat, and so on. So if you notice, the shape of the wave is something of this kind. So can I say that this is an oscillating wave? Definitely, yes. This is an oscillating wave. But rather, this is not a traveling wave. How can you say that this is not a traveling wave? Please observe the maxima or minima. Now, this is the location where you are having the maxima or minima. At time instant 1, where are you having the maxima? At time instant 1, this is the location of maxima. This is the location of minima. At time instant 2, this is the location of maxima. This is the location of minima. At time instant 3, entirely the function is 0. At time instant 4, this is the minima, whereas this is the maxima. And at time instant, you can say 5, this is the minima, whereas this is a maxima. So overall, I can say that this is the location of maxima or minima. Yes, either you are having at this location maxima or minima. Similarly, can I say this is one more location of maxima or minima? Yes, and again, this is one more location where you are having a maxima or minima. At various instances of time, the maxima or minima will be decided. That is, as I told you, at time instant 1 as well as 2, this point, that is nothing but at this location, you are having a maxima, whereas at 4 and 5, you are having at the same location minima. But the location of maxima or minima, is it changing with respect to time? No. So that is what is very important here. So whether you take a maxima or minima, the location of maxima or minima is not moving forward in distance whenever time changes. So because of which, can you transfer some energy by using this, you can say, wave? Obviously no. So this wave can't be used to transfer energy. Energy can be transferred whenever the wave moves in one direction. In this case, the wave is not moving in any direction. This is simply oscillating around some, I can say, mean value. So because that mean value is nothing but zero value. So since this function is oscillating around zero, I can say that this function cannot be used in order to transfer any information from one location to the another location. So this is about how a standing wave changes its shape with respect to time. And we concluded that here this wave is similar to a oscillating wave, but not a traveling wave. And hence no energy can be transferred by means of a standing wave. Let us say I take one more scenario with respect to the standing waves. We know that standing wave is produced whenever we have two traveling waves traveling in opposite directions. So let us say I am having a function u of x comma t, which is equal to a cos of omega t minus beta x. This is forward wave or backward wave? This is a forward wave. And the other traveling wave is a cos of omega t plus beta x, just like in the previous case. So just by looking at this plus sign, the minus sign here says that this is a forward wave, and the plus sign here says that this is a backward wave. Backward means it travels in the negative direction of x. And earlier, how much is the phase angle we have taken other than omega t minus beta x? It was 0. Here also we have taken omega t plus beta x, other than that it was nothing but 0. But now let us introduce some phase change. So I'll write it as phi naught. So now the phase angle of forward wave and backward wave are not same. So I want to observe what is the effect of phi naught in the overall standing wave pattern. Let us see now. Now this is similar to what, amplitudes are same, frequencies are same. So I can take the amplitudes common, and whenever I take the amplitudes common, what do you have now? You have the equation as A into cos of omega t minus beta x plus cos of omega t plus beta x plus phi naught. And this is cos A plus cos B. What is the trigonometric relation of cos A plus cos B? This is equal to 2 cos A plus B by 2 into cos of A minus B by 2. And whenever you apply that relation, in the present case, I am simply writing the answer, just cross verify that mathematics. You will get the equation as 2A naught. Whenever you add them, what will happen? Beta x and beta x are gone. Omega t and omega t becomes 2 omega t plus phi naught. And anyway, you are having by 2. So because which it becomes equal to cos of omega t plus phi naught by 2. And the second term, which is a space term, becomes how much? This is the cos of. And whenever you take the difference now, omega t and omega t are gone. Minus beta x becomes minus 2 beta x. And minus phi naught we have. And you can take that minus completely outside. So in that case, you will have cos of beta x plus phi naught by 2. So what is the difference between this equation and the equation that we have got earlier? Whenever phi naught is 0, whenever phi naught is 0, we got the equation as 2a naught cos of omega t cos of beta x. Because of the phase change that you have introduced here, you are having a temporal phase change of phi naught by 2, as well as a spatial phase change of phi naught by 2. This is a temporal phase change. Whereas this is a spatial phase change. So it simply means that your standing wave pattern will be shifted in space, nothing else. So the standing wave pattern will be shifted in space. And by how much amount of phase your standing wave pattern will be shifted? By an amount of phi naught by 2. What about the amplitude? Amplitude didn't change for us. So it doesn't matter whether you are having some finite phase change or zero phase change. Still, what happens is the amplitude of your standing wave will not change. Only thing that changes is the spatial phase change as well as the temporal phase change. We are not much concerned about the temporal phase change, but rather we are much concerned about the spatial phase change. And we should know exactly how this spatial phase change will occur. So simply at this point, remember one thing, that a phase change introduced in the backward wave or a forward wave, doesn't matter where, will lead to a spatial phase change in the standing wave pattern. This is nothing but what? This is us of x comma t. So this is a standing wave pattern. So we will have a phase change in the standing wave pattern by a magnitude of phi naught by 2. So that is the conclusion of this discussion. So till now we have seen waves which are either purely a traveling wave or purely a standing wave. But let us say I'm having a wave which consists of both the components. So what is the generalized expression of such kind of a wave? So that's what we are about to discuss in this general wave. Here in this context, whenever I say general wave, we mean to say a wave which has both standing wave component as well as a traveling wave component. So in this case, general wave corresponds to a wave which has a standing wave component as well as traveling wave component. And this discussion is very, very important because this will be applied in electromagnetic waves as well as the transmission line power calculations. Okay. So let us say I am having a couple of waves, both are traveling waves, and their amplitude is not same. Frequency of both the waves are same, but rather the amplitude is not same. Furthermore, one of these traveling waves is a forward traveling wave and the other traveling wave is a backward traveling wave. So here we are having two traveling waves. One forward and one backward. And these traveling waves have the same frequency, but rather their amplitudes is not same. So they have same frequency, but rather they have, let us say, different amplitudes and different phases. We know that whenever we have two traveling waves, one forward and one backward, with same frequency and same amplitude, in that case that creates a purely standing wave. But now I am having a scenario where the frequency is same, but rather the amplitude is not same. And in fact, even you can change the phase, changing the phase will not create much of a difference for us. So let us say the phases are also different. Now in this case, the generalized form of the equation can be written in this form: u of x comma t is equal to a cos of omega t minus beta x plus b cos of omega t plus beta x plus phi naught. Now can I say that this is a forward wave? Yes. So this is a forward wave having an amplitude of how much? A. And whereas this is a backward wave, how can we say that this is a backward wave? Just by noticing the sign here. So this is a backward wave . Do they have the same frequency? Yes, here the frequency is, angular frequency is omega, here also omega. But what about amplitudes? Amplitudes are different. The forward wave has an amplitude of A and the backward wave has an amplitude of B. And let us say the value of A is greater than B. Furthermore, we have a phase difference between the forward wave as well as the backward wave, and that phase difference is phi naught. We have taken a generalized scenario. Now, how can I rewrite this expression? I will rewrite this expression in this format. I will write it as A minus B into cos of omega t minus beta x plus B cos of omega t minus beta x plus. If you notice, what are these two terms? If I add these two terms, ultimately what do you get? Here also we are having cos of omega t minus beta x, here also cos of omega t minus beta x. And if I take cos terms common, what will I get as amplitude now? A minus B plus B. What is A minus B plus B? It is nothing but A. Indicates we are simply splitting the forward wave into two components. This is one component, this is one more component. So these are the components of simply the forward wave. And backward wave, I'll write it as it is. And in that case, I'll get it as B cos of omega t plus beta x plus the phase difference phi naught. Now please observe, forget about the first term. What about the second and third terms? Do they have same amplitudes? Yes. Do they have same frequency? Yes. Phase, I don't have to bother. Can I call this wave as a standing wave? Yes, because this is traveling in forward direction, this is traveling in backward direction. Same frequency, same amplitude. So because which, this is a standing wave. And what about this wave? This is a traveling wave. This is a purely traveling wave. So if you very clearly notice again that the forward wave started with how much amount of energy? or how much amount of power? Proportional to A square. But because of the backward wave, what happened? Because of backward wave having an amplitude of B, a part of the forward wave has been cancelled out in the form of a standing wave. So this component of the forward wave has been cancelled out by your backward wave. So how much net amount of power you are transferring from one location to another location? Proportional to this amplitude. Because that guy will not transfer any energy. Only the traveling wave will transfer the energy. And that power that is transferred is proportional to how much? It is proportional to A minus B whole square. So even though I have incident an amount of power which is proportional to A square, ultimately how much is the net amount of power? Net amount of power is proportional to A minus B whole square. So because which presence of the backward waves or presence of the standing waves in our overall pattern will lead to a reduction of power transfer from one location to the other location. So because which as much as possible we try to avoid this standing wave. So to avoid this standing wave we should have a perfect matching. The concept of matching is similar to the maximum power transfer theorem that you use in networks. The purpose of maximum power transfer theorem is what? To transfer as much maximum power to the load as possible. Here also to transfer maximum power we are supposed to have a concept called matching, and whenever you have matching the reflected components or the backward wave components will be eliminated, and whenever the backward components are eliminated the entire wave consists of only the forward wave so that the power transfer can be as much maximum as possible. Let us now look at the differences between a traveling wave and a standing wave. Traveling wave, as the name implies, it travels in space. So this wave travels in space. Standing wave do not travel in space, but rather it oscillates. So standing wave do not travel in space, but it simply oscillates in space with respect to time. One common example, that is the day-to-day example that we can say give for traveling wave, is a wave produced on water when a stone is dropped. Whenever a stone is dropped, you see that ripples are created, and these ripples carry or travel away from the point where the stone has been dropped. Whereas a standing wave, an example, is nothing but waves on top of string of a guitar. So waves on the string of a guitar, they do not travel. They simply oscillate around the point where the string has been plucked. So because which the example of standing wave is nothing but the waves on top of the guitar string. Traveling waves since they travel, they can transfer energy from one location to another location. So they can transfer energy from one location to the other. Whereas standing wave, they do not travel or they do not transfer energy from one location to the other. But rather they can store energy. They do store energy. Further, in traveling wave, the location of maximum amplitude or minimum amplitude that will change with respect to time. So here in traveling wave, the location of maximum or minimum amplitude changes with respect to time. Whereas in case of standing wave, the location of maxima or minima is always fixed. So here the location of peak values is fixed. So only at certain locations along the space we will have the function to be either maxima or minima. In traveling waves, since they are traveling, any travel will have some direction, right? So because which the traveling waves are associated with direction. Whereas in case of standing wave, since they do not travel, there is no specific direction associated with respect to the standing wave. So there is no direction of travel. Because they do not travel. So since they do not travel, there is no direction of travel associated with the standing wave.
So let me just summarize everything that we have discussed about waves. We have started by defining what exactly a wave is. A wave is any physical quantity which is a function of space and time, which satisfies the wave equation. After that, we have seen the classification of waves, and initially we have studied about the longitudinal waves. In longitudinal waves, the direction of oscillation of the particle as well as the direction of propagation both will be the same. And examples of longitudinal waves are sound waves. And after that, we have seen transverse waves. In transverse waves, the direction of oscillation of the particle as well as the direction of propagation both are perpendicular. And one example of transverse waves is electromagnetic waves. And since in our course of electromagnetics, we are dealing with EM waves, transverse waves is of interest for us. We don't study about the longitudinal waves. And further, the transverse waves can be classified into two categories. They can be either a traveling wave or it can be a standing wave. In a traveling wave, the wave moves in one direction of space, and in that process it transfers energy from one location to the other. So simply, traveling waves travel, and in that process of travel they transfer energy from one location to the other. And by using the concept of traveling waves, we have defined what exactly is a standing wave. A standing wave is definitely a function which changes with respect to space and time, but rather it is not traveling, in the sense that it is not transferring energy from one location to the other. And we have seen that a standing wave is formed whenever two traveling waves having same amplitude and frequency travels in opposite directions. And we have further seen many other cases of standing waves. For example, whenever the phase of both traveling waves are not same, in that case what will happen to the standing wave that is formed, etc., etc. And in the end, we have seen a general wave. A general wave is a wave which has both standing wave component as well as a traveling wave component. And how the energy is transferred in case of a general wave, that also we have seen. Now let me use some animations in order to explain all these concepts. So in this, we are having some space, and let me introduce a wave in this space. So here we have a wave. So let us say from left to right is the positive direction of x. So x is the space parameter I'm taking here, and from left to right we are having the x direction. And if you notice, the amplitude of the wave at any location, is it not changing with respect to time? Yes, here if you notice, whenever time changes, the amplitude of the wave will change. So can I say that this is a function of time? Definitely yes. Let us almost pause this animation. Now in this case, if you observe, this is at some instant of time. Assume as if the animation is stopped. Now in this case, is the amplitude a function of distance? Yes, if this is a reference, left end is a reference for us. With respect to the left end, at various locations in space, I'm having various amplitudes. So whenever I fix the time, that is, I stop the time. So in that case, again, if you notice, the amplitude is a function of space. So I can say that amplitude is a function of both space and time. So because of which, can I call this function as a wave or this quantity as a wave? Yes, so this is a wave. And furthermore, is it a transverse wave or a longitudinal wave? This wave is a transverse wave. How can you say? Please tell me, what is the direction in which the wave is traveling? It is traveling towards the right direction, which we can call it as the x direction. So the wave is traveling in the direction of x. Notice in which direction the maximum value is moving. The maximum value or peak value is moving in the forward direction. So because of which, I can say that this is a wave traveling in the x direction. But what is the direction of oscillation of the particles? The particles are oscillating perpendicular to the x direction. If I call this direction as nothing but the y direction. This is x, so I can call this as y. And if this is y direction, the particles are oscillating along the y direction. It may be plus y or minus y, it doesn't matter. They are oscillating along the y direction, which is perpendicular to x. So indicates, in this case, the particles are oscillating along y direction and the wave is propagating along x direction. So because of which, this is a transverse wave. Further, in transverse wave, is this a traveling wave or is it a standing wave? The answer is, it is a traveling wave. How to notice whether a wave is traveling wave or a standing wave? Simply notice that if the peak value moves in one direction of space, so in that case, we will call that wave as a traveling wave. And this wave is traveling in what direction? This wave is traveling in the direction. Notice always with respect to time, whenever you increase the time. Now in that case, the wave is moving in what direction? The peak value is moving in the direction of positive x. As I told you, towards right side is the direction of positive x. So because which, this wave is traveling in the direction of positive x. So this is a positive traveling wave. Let me reverse the direction. Now if you notice, in which direction this wave is traveling? First of all, is it a traveling wave? Yes, because the peak value, if you notice, the peak value is moving in some direction. So because which, I can say that this is a traveling wave. And in what direction this peak value is moving? This peak value is moving in the direction of minus x. So because which, this is a wave which is traveling in the direction of minus x. So this is a negative traveling wave. Now let me take two waves. So this is a wave one, this is a wave two. And let me change the amplitude just to show the second wave. Now here we have two waves. Both of these waves, are they traveling waves? Yes. And are they traveling in the same direction? Again, yes. So when two traveling waves travel in same direction, the resultant is always one more traveling wave. You can observe here, the blue wave is a resultant of red and green waves. Now the blue wave, is it a traveling wave? Definitely yes. If you notice, the peak value, it is moving in one direction, that is the positive direction of x. So because which, I can say that the resultant of red and green waves is also one more traveling wave. That is because both the traveling waves, that is wave 1 as well as wave 2, are traveling in the same direction. So when two traveling waves travel in the same direction, the resultant is one more traveling wave. Let me reverse the direction of one of the waves now and observe what will happen. Now this is what I have done. Here I am having by the way, I'll keep the amplitude same. Okay, I kept the amplitudes of both the waves same. And in that process, what happened for you? You notice that the peak value is not moving. the resultant, this is the blue wave, is a resultant wave. The resultant wave is having a peak value which is located only at a fixed point in space. This is a location where I'm having the peak value, or this is a location where I'm having the peak value, or this is a location where I'm having the peak value. But none of these peak values are moving in space. They are simply oscillating about a point in space, but rather they are not traveling in space. So this wave, will it transfer any energy? Obviously no. So from one end, this end, left end to the right end, I can't transfer any energy by using a standing wave. And the red wave is moving towards left, the green wave is moving towards right. So indicates, again, we have two traveling waves having the same amplitude, having the same frequency. Notice the amplitude, both the waves are having an amplitude of 5. Both the waves are having a wavelength of 8. If wavelength is same, frequency is also same. So when two traveling waves travel in opposite directions, in that case, we will have a standing wave being formed. Now let me do one thing. I'll change the phase difference. I'll change the phase difference between both the waves. Whenever I change the phase difference, still earlier the phase difference was 0. Now I change the phase difference to 180 degrees. Notice now also, are you having a standing wave? Yes. And did the amplitude change for you? No. Exactly like in the previous case, whatever is the amplitude you're having like in the previous case, the exact amplitude you're having now also. So just because you are having a phase displacement in case of the traveling waves doesn't mean that overall in a standing wave the amplitude will change. But what has changed as compared to the previous case? What has changed? Please notice at this point, in the present case with 180 degrees phase difference, at this point, are we having a zero or a maximum? We are having a zero. We are not having a peak value. Whereas this is a location where you are having a peak value. Now, whenever the phase difference is zero, whenever the phase difference is zero, notice now at x equals zero, that is at this one end, at this point itself, you are having the peak value. That is, earlier wherever you had a zero, now you are having a peak value. And this is a location where earlier you had a peak value. This is a location where now you are having a zero. Just to show you, I'll further change the phase angle. The phase angle has been changed to 180 degrees now. Now in this case, when phase angle was, or phase difference was zero, this is a location where you had maxima, but now at the same location you are having a zero. So this is the effect of phase change. Whenever you introduce some phase difference between the forward and backward waves, in that case what will happen is that standing wave will simply shift in space. And it will shift by what angle? It shifts by an angle of 5/2. If you remember, what was the phase shift that was introduced in our equation? The equation that we got with phase difference was 2a0 cos of omega t plus phi0/2 into cos of beta x plus phi0/2. So the phase difference that we have introduced was 90 degrees, or I can say 5/2. And in this example, first case 0 degrees, second case 180 degrees. How much is the phase difference? The phase difference is over 180 degrees. And how much is the phase shift you are having in the standing wave pattern? In the standing wave, the phase difference is 180/2, which is 90 degrees. Notice that is the reason why, as compared to the previous case, wherever you had a peak value, that is where you had a zero. So indicates the wave has been shifted by a distance of how much? λ/4. That is this point and this point. How much is the distance? It will be simply λ/4. And how much is the phase shift corresponding to λ/4? It is nothing but lambda corresponds to what? 2π radians phase shift. So 2π/4 means π/2. So π/2 is a phase shift that you are having in the present case. That is exactly what we had got in the form of equations also. Now let me do one very interesting thing. Let me change the amplitude of backward wave, that is negative wave. Whenever I change the amplitude of the negative wave, notice now that the forward wave has larger amplitude, whereas the backward wave has a smaller amplitude. Now what is the resultant of the given case? The blue wave, is it a standing wave or a traveling wave? According to one sense, it looks like a standing wave because we are having some oscillations, just like in case of a standing wave. In standing wave, were we not having oscillations? Yes. So here we do have oscillations, just like the case of the standing wave. But if I notice, this is a peak value. This peak value, is it moving forward in space? Definitely yes. So indicates what? Does it have a traveling wave component? Yes. So this is a general wave where we are having both standing wave as well as the traveling wave. So this wave, the resultant wave, is nothing but a combination of one standing wave as well as one traveling wave. So this is a few concepts. These are a few concepts about the waves. Whatever we have discussed in the form of equations, now we have seen in the form of some animations. I hope these animations have helped you much better understand the concept of waves. Thank you.